Hello everyone, welcome to Topper IAS. So as part of our daily series, today also we will discuss the news which is taken from Hindu as well as source from PIB. Okay, so let's get started. So the first one is with respect to monsoonal rainfall. So IMD has given an estimation of what has happened so far in last 2 months. So what the heading of the article is, rise in extreme rainfall events. So there has been significant variation in rainfall across the country, meaning the monsoonal rainfall is, you already know, it is not uniform, but now it has this uninformity has increased. So extremity in the variation is being seen. So according to the IMD data on regional distribution, South Peninsula has seen 29% more rainfall than normal during last 2 months, like June 1 to July 23, whereas in the same period Northwest and Central India have seen 10% and 2% of deficit rainfall respectively, and even Northeast India has seen a 14% deficit. Actually this region has a higher base rainfall, but it has, even this region has seen deficit. So you see there one region getting excess of rain up to 30%, whereas one region seeing a deficit of 15%. So a lot of extreme variation in the rainfall is what the IMD is saying. And this is in line with what climate scientists have warned, that the monsoon patterns overall have been changing because of the climate change and all those stuff. So as per the study published in the Climate Dynamics, so there are certain factual steps which point out to extremity in the extreme variation in the rainfall. So things like, there is the frequency and strength of cyclones over Arabian Sea has increased in the past 2 decades. Okay, there has been a 52% increase in the frequency of cyclones over Arabian Sea from 2001 to 2019. So cyclones formation, frequency of cyclone formation has increased in Arabian Sea, particularly by 52%, okay, by 2001 to 2019. Whereas between 1980 to 2002, there has been decrease in the number of cyclones formed in Bay of Bengal, 8%. But you see, historically what was the case was, Bay of Bengal used to find more cyclones formed in Bay of Bengal compared to Arabian Sea, but now the trend has reversed. So you are seeing more cyclones being formed in Arabian Sea compared to Bay of Bengal, and even the duration of these cyclones has increased by 80%. So moment the duration of cyclone is increasing, obviously prolonged extreme rainfall events is what is going to see. Okay, so this is the map which is given. You can just go through it, okay, the deficit and the excess rainfall. The next one is with respect to secrecy. Supreme Court says secrecy of vote must be in any election. So Supreme Court on Friday held that in any election, election be it to a parliament or be it to a state legislature, maintenance of secrecy of voting is a must. And it says that secrecy is a part of fundamental right of freedom of speech and expression. So Article 19, you have freedom of speech and expression, right? So secrecy is a part of this Article 19. And why it is important? Because the confidentiality of the choice will be strengthening the democracy is what it is saying. Because it ensures that the voter who cast his vote without any fear and being victimized if his vote is disclosed. See, a person, obviously the chances of getting victimized if he votes against a particular popular candidate, such things will happen, right, within a villages and all this stuff during the elections. So if there is a secrecy of voting, meaning if nobody knows to whom he is voting, obviously he is unlikely to be victimized by any rival parties. And Supreme Court also said that booth capturing and bogus voting should be dealt with iron hands, because it ultimately affects the rule of law and democracy, and nobody can be permitted to dilute the right of free and fair elections. So obviously the moment these people capture the booth and vote, obviously it is not a free and fair election, right? And free and fair elections and democracy, these are nothing. These are actually part of basic structure of constitution. That's why you have to protect it. And secrecy should be maintained in all elections is what the Supreme Court has said. The next one is with respect to firecrackers. Supreme Court has upheld the NGT ban on firecrackers. See, basically the issue in Delhi NCR region, right? So pollution issue. So on that background, NGT had banned the firecrackers, and the appeal was made to Supreme Court now. So Supreme Court dismissed the challenge of dismissed the petition which was challenging this NGT ban on the sale and use of firecrackers during COVID pandemic. So what the petitioner said that this is against their business, their livelihood will be affected. But Supreme Court tribunal had said earlier that right to do business is not absolute. There is no right to violate air quality and noise level norms is what the NGT had said, and it has banned the firecrackers. So remember that. The next one, a basic thing with respect to National Green Tribunal. See, it is a specialized body set up under particular act. So the act name is also National Green Tribunal Act. So why was it set up? It was set up for effective and expeditious disposal of cases relating to environmental protection and conservation of forest. So in the environmental sphere, all the cases will be dealt by NGT. Okay. So with the establishment of NGT, India became third country in the world to set up a specialized environmental tribunal after Australia and New Zealand. So remember that. Then NGT is mandated. So what is the main work of NGT? So disposal of applications or appeals within the 6 months of the filing of the case. Okay. So meaning is, so obviously what is the purpose of setting tribunal? For expeditious disposal, right? So it has been told to dispose the cases within 6 months. So, and other factual stuff is NGT has 5 places of sittings. So New Delhi is the principal place of sitting, whereas Bhopal, Pune, Kolkata, Chennai are the other 4 regions. So that's it for today. You can download the PDF of this document in the link that is shared below, and do download Top Arise Institute app so that you get access to n number of these videos. Thank you.